Hi everyone, so let me introduce myself. My name is Fadil Rashid, NIM 2007884, and I'm here with my friend.
Hello everyone, my name is Tiara Clarissa Permana Putri. My NIM number is 2007393. We are here today to present about the Library of Universitas Indonesia. So let's get started.
First, I would like to tell you about the history of this building. The Library of Universitas Indonesia, or usually called the Crystal of Knowledge, was built in 2009, completed and inaugurated on 13th of May 2011. The location of this building is in Universitas Indonesia, Depok City, West Java.
The architect of the Library of Universitas Indonesia is Budiman Hendro Purnomo. It functioned as the Central Library of Universitas Indonesia, but also has other functions like garden, restaurant, bank, and bookstore.
This building costs about 170 billion rupiah. Although this university has an architecture department, but they held an international competition to design this building, and the selected design is from the MC Architect Company. This building uses the green architecture concept, that the general goal is that green architecture is designed to reduce the impact of the built environment on human health and natural environment by efficient in using energy, water, and also reducing waste and pollution.
The exterior wall of this building is andesite stone, and it has advantage of not needing to reapply the paint. And also, they use environmentally friendly materials by increasing the greenery and garden to balance the surrounding environment. The interior of the building is made open and interconnected between one room and another with a void system to maximize the use of natural air circulation. The interior is also environmentally friendly by reducing the use of electricity and using polymer stone and wood instead of glass to reduce the indoor temperature.
The Library of Universitas Indonesia applies the concept of sustainable building. For instance, they use solar energy as the sustainability measure. The roofs of this building are developed into roof gardens, which have high ecological value. 60% of this building was covered by soil and grass. There are waterways between that grass. Raindrops will pour into infiltration soil through the waterways, and the glass is for lightning system.
This library holds up to 5 million items and used by up to 20,000 people a day. The library is one of the largest in Asia. As we all know, the library is a place to read books, but some people come to the Library of Universitas Indonesia not only to read books. They also write essays or tasks, buy some books, have lunch, buy a coffee, chilling out, etc.